time for brief applause. Featuring stories from the WVIZ-PBS Emmy Award-winning arts and culture program, Applause, with your host, Dee Perry.
Now, let's meet one of the WPA's last remaining local artists, Charles Saleh. Saleh worked for the WPA between 1936 and 1941. He became widely known throughout Northeast Ohio for his portraiture and interior design skills. Now in his 90s, Saleh still shares the love for life his artwork captured so vividly. Join us now as we paint a portrait of the artist, Charles Saleh.
I've been drawing ever since I was 4 years old, so literally I like to draw anything that moved.
At the age of 4 years old, he was fascinated by the fact that people would go into the water and dive in the water and disappear and then reappear, and that was something that fascinated him, and he would sit and draw that constantly when he was a child.
Charles Louis Saleh Jr. was born in 1911 in Oberlin, Ohio. His family later moved to Sandusky, where Charles Sr. started a construction firm. Charles Jr. graduated from Sandusky High School, where he was the resident artist.
He was always very active drawing while he was in school. Most of the plays or the yearbooks and all of that type of thing he was very active in.
The Saleh family belonged to Sandusky's Second Baptist Church, the site of a stop on the Underground Railroad. Charles Sr. helped construct a new building for the church in the 1920s.
He had a good understanding about art, and I appreciated when he picked out something to do. It just thrilled me. I got the biggest hook out of was doing some murals in churches.
Charles Jr. would later help his father finish Second Baptist with an artistic touch.
In the frames that my father had prepared in the 20s, I think about in the 40s or 50s, a missionary society asked him to do paintings of John the Baptist and Jesus, and of Jesus carrying the cross.
Charles's talents also included music, but it was visual art he longed to master.
I started listening to violinists, and I heard Yasha Heifetz, and I said, nope. I couldn't imagine myself playing that way, because there were so many other situations where I could always imagine myself doing a better job. And so I had the same attitude when I went to art school.
Charles was the first African American to attend and graduate from the Cleveland School of Art, now the Cleveland Institute of Art. It was there that he studied under teachers like designer Victor Schreckengost and Paul Travis of the renowned Cleveland School.
He was here at a very, very interesting, important time, not only because of the Cleveland School, also Charles himself was affiliated with the Harlem Renaissance. He was acquainted with very, very important key members of the movement, including Langston Hughes, the poet, and Romare Bearden, the painter.
Between 1936 and 1941, Charles painted public murals and made prints for the Federal Art Project of the Works Progress Administration, or WPA.
For the WPA, I did murals in schools and other public buildings, because I can remember painting the murals above the chalkboards. The chalkboards wouldn't go all the way to the ceiling, so the space between the top of the chalkboard and the ceiling is where I would paint the murals.
He did incredible murals throughout the Cleveland area, most of which have been destroyed. Originally, his works were painted on walls in buildings that are now torn down.
One of Saleh's last remaining WPA murals is from 1940, located at the Portland Outhwaite Homes in Cleveland's Central Avenue District.
It is a grand mural of people moving out of poverty into a brand new federally funded building and or project unit. And it exudes the joy and the pride of people moving up.
Charles was also invited to teach at the Karamu House, joining other influential artists like Huey Lee Smith and William E. Smith. Saleh's favorite form of expression is portraiture, and one of his most important portraits is of a Karamu dancer named Bertha.
she was just striking, an inspiration. That was one of the things that I probably went through maybe four or five times in my career, where I'd see somebody would just blow me away. Oh, I gotta draw them. There's some people, it just hits you. You just put the pencil down and it draws itself.
In the people he painted, Charles discovered a genuine love for life, despite the era in which he lived.
In the piece with the dancer, Jukebox Jive, if you look at that picture, you can see Charles's vitality at the particular time that he worked on that picture.
Charles painted in a way where he was really focusing on someone's personality. He was connecting with that person, and many of them radiate a sense of personality, which is unusual. And with the piece Jitterbug, for example, you could almost hear the music when you look at this piece. You get a sense of these people just having the time of their lives dancing, you know, to this music. So that's actually quite rare.
While a number of Charles Sallé's greatest works have been destroyed or lost, his legacy remains intact.
I have two daughters who are both into art. They don't do what I do. They work with computers. I wouldn't know how to start a computer.
Where did all that time go?
Yes, where does it go?
We need to take stock in the traditions that we have and the people that were very important in forming not only the history of the Institute, but the history of art in Cleveland needs to be celebrated more, needs to be brought to the public's awareness more, and Charles is really a perfect example of that.
For more stories on Northeast Ohio's rich and vibrant cultural community, tune into Applause with Dee Perry, Thursday nights at 7:30 on WVIZ-PBS. Be sure to join Dee for Around Noon, weekdays at noon on 90.3 WCPN, shining the spotlight on our local arts and culture scene.